I think it's the first developer talk today. It's about SQL, and all the talks before me were about roughly administration stuff and more for administrations. And this is real for development. Yeah, improve your SQL. Wait, let's see if it works. No, it won't work. Doesn't matter. I'm gonna take this.
It's on.
It doesn't matter. So I have some rules, like every speaker. I can't do an individual consulting within this talk. Of course, it's very important. My slides don't have any standalone meaning. So when you find the slides later on in the internet, I'm pretty sure I will upload them. You can't say, "Oh, that's faster than that. Look at this slide." No, you have to hear what I say to that slide because they have no standalone meaning. And of course, the copyright, my slides, don't copy them, and so on. Oh, that's okay. So who am I? My name is Susanne Holzgräfe. I married in 2014. It was very funny because nobody knows me anymore. But I was the first female developer at the PostgreSQL project. And I worked for MySQL AB in Sweden, worked for Sun, worked for Oracle. And then I left. And today I'm working as freelance consultant for MariaDB, MySQL and PostgreSQL. So I don't mind what you use, I just will help you. I don't mind what system you use. That's me. I mostly do it in Germany or close to Germany, Belgium, Netherlands, London, all what's good to reach from Germany because I made it worldwide and had so much long distance flights that I said, okay, I need to retire, I just need to do it in my own area. So, CTE, Common Table Expressions. I think it was in 2010 or so, PostgreSQL implemented Common Table Expressions. And I said, wow, that's great. Especially because you had, you see it, you had a real performance gain of it, measured to correlated subselect. And I said, well, that's great. So I implemented it in my standard default trainings since today. And last year, I listened to a talk from Peter Zaitsev. He introduced CTEs in MySQL 8.0. I said, okay. And I know MariaDB, I think the version of MariaDB was half a year earlier released than MySQL. So they now both also have CTEs, and I really love CTEs. And so I said, I will speak about it. And as I said, in PostgreSQL, the big performance gain you have in correlated subselects. Who is using correlated subselects? Oh, let me show you what it is, correlated subselects. Just remember, it was when you have an outer select, which you are using in the inner select here. So where inner bar is outer bar. That's a correlated subselect. Who has such use cases or know somebody who has such use cases? Okay. I have lots of customers having these use cases. Very often I see queries with correlated subselects because they just have this use case. And when they have, and usually they are really slow. It's often a complaint, the query is too slow. And this is a common table expression. Common table expressions start with. And a common table expression is like a view. You have a view before the original select. So here you first have a view, you first select the average what you need, and then make a join from the table, joining the table with your view, and forgetting the result. Yeah. As I said, in PostgreSQL, this is a big, or it was a big performance gain. And I had customers, they said, my query needs 20 minutes. I helped them to rewrite it to common table expressions, and the query finished in 2 seconds. It was a real gain. I won. The customer booked me again. Today, it's not so fast, or the common table expression still is same fast, but the optimizer just got better on the correlated subselects. So that the performance gain difference isn't so big anymore, but there's still a performance gain. But there's not just the performance gain, it's also, I think it's better readable. You see it in my examples. When you have this before, this is just better readable. I have one example here, it's an easy one. It's a ticket system. You know there's penalties for wrong parking and so on. It's a test DB I made. It's 2 or 3 tables and 1 million rows today. Randomly, I randomly filled. So, okay, that's a complex query. Honestly, I have a second complex, more complex query, and for I sometimes think about my, what the hell is this thing doing? It's same here. And when I have it in a CTE, it's much pretty clearer what it's doing because you don't have the subselect and subselect and so on. So you will have a better understanding. It's easier to read. So that's an easy one. I just wanted to know which towns got more money by than the duration. So top towns in ticket form, parking ticket penalties. When I prepared the slides, I set up 2 VMs, 2 virtual machines, on the same machine, on the same host. 1 core or 2 cores, I can't remember exactly similar. Also, I installed by using the packages, the Debian packages from the download pages of mysql.org and mariadb.org. And yeah, I set up InnoDB buffer pool a little bit. Both identically to my RAM. So, and I had, by accident, I had on my computer, I had a PostgreSQL running. It isn't the actual version, so it doesn't matter, because I know what happens on PostgreSQL. So I run this query, I set up this test database on this 2 systems. Yeah, and the performance gain on this query, as I said, 1 million rows. MySQL 8.0.14, the CTE query needs half of the time as the subselect. Just to compare, my PostgreSQL needed a third of the time. It doesn't matter. MariaDB has no performance difference at the moment in CTEs or subqueries. Somebody of the developers told me yesterday he knows why. I couldn't find out a performance gain in MariaDB, but in MySQL I also have a huge performance gain. As I said today, the optimizers are much better in subqueries than a few years ago. So that's a more complex query. You see it here, and that's something I always ask me, what the hell is it doing? No, I know it, but yeah. So that's a typical query I get from customers. Sometimes more often, more complex, and when I ask the customer what he's doing, and I get lots of complaining. So with the risk query, I see, okay, here we have, give me the top towns again, who made the violation, most get money of violations, and then split it again, select something from them. So that's a CTE rewrite. And that's the performance gain. MySQL, there's a 10% faster. Even PostgreSQL just is two-thirds fast, needs two-thirds of the time. Variety with no performance gain. I know from PostgreSQL when the queries are too complex, then you also have no performance gain. So you always have to test if it's still there. It depends on how much you need to cache in the view. And I guess it's similar to MySQL, and my machine just was smaller here. That's CTE. That's a one, as I said, CTE, it's a real good feature. I once had a training. It was a MySQL training, or this training company said it's a MySQL training. But you know, big companies, the employee isn't allowed to book the training by his own. So there is somebody in the company booking this training. And I think this guy who booked the training thought the Y in MySQL is a typo. So all the guys, all the students in this training wanted MS SQL instead of MySQL. It was a developer training, and I figured out, they were fit on writing CTEs. It was when it just was implemented in PostgreSQL. So I was so surprised. So since then I know CTEs are very well known in MS SQL. I didn't know before, but CTEs. But there's another fancy stuff you can do with CTEs, that's recursion. Just one example, recursion, you can write recursive queries with using CTEs. This just counts the numbers from 1 to 100, 5050 will be the result. You can do such stuff. I know that's always when CTEs are introduced, always say, hey, we can do recursion. I've never seen this in, also at PostgreSQL, it's 10 years now. I've never seen a customer using CTEs for recursion. Usually they use it for rewriting complex queries or really correlated subselects. But you can do it. It's nice. Yeah, that's something neither MySQL nor MariaDB today have implemented, but maybe that's the future, that you can do CTEs also in DML, so in delete or insert or update. Delete, insert, or update. Just a feature. Yeah. Let me look. I have no time there. So, any questions up to here? No? Okay. Because I have a second topic here, it's window functions. Window functions are, I don't know when they were implemented in the MySQL MariaDBs. I think roughly 10 years ago, somebody here from the developers knows it. Since when window functions? You don't know. Yeah, it's some years in both in MariaDB and MySQL. But they are still very unknown. That's why I thought, okay, I take this as second topic. Window functions make a window from a result, or make a petition. So, it's easier to explain it by examples. I made the average example. You can do window functions on almost all aggregates. I just took here the average function and I made a new table with violations, number of violations in town, just because I not wanted millions of results, just 10. So, What is it doing here? It's doing the average over partition by town. So the average of number of violations over partition by town. Partition by town, not group by town, partition by town from violation. And this is the result. This is the result on MariaDB. You will see the MySQL result is similar. You see at the end that you have the average of, for example, of Aachen. And the average of Bielefeld and the average of Essen at the end. And it's the average of these three violations and not just for the single one. When you do it by group by, you will get an average for each row and not partitioned by this town. You also can do it with sum and other aggregate functions. I filled the tables randomly. That's why you have different values in the average and in the number of violations in MySQL, but the result is similar. Also, performance, I didn't feel any performance here because it's just 10 rows in a table. So not so much. But it's a really great feature when you need some average. It's really a use case I have really often, not with average, but with some. Another example or one of great feature which I see my customer using very, very often is WANK. WANK, here we have, I wanted to rank the charge, and partitioned by town, order by charge, of course, is a price. It's money, DESC. As rank, and I figured out when I made the test that rank is a reserved keyword in MySQL. Almost all these window functions are reserved keywords in MySQL. So in MySQL I took underscore rank instead of rank for naming it. So, and the result for the ranking is, you see, you have here Aachen. This is one, this is rank top, this is the second. You have here top on Bielefeld is driving without license, and second, for a third, and so on. And top of Essen is driving without, driving without license, and the other is driving under alcohol is at the end. So you can have a ranking. I see this very often used in online games. I have some gaming customers, and of course they like this function for ranking. But rank very often is used. We have another feature, or two other features. MySQL, similar results. Same here. Lack. Lack and lead, you can do this window functions, this window. Also, you don't just have the keyword partition here. You also can do something like over order by something. And be careful, when I made the slide for lack, I made it DESC for lead, I make it without. We will see it later. So, lack. What's doing it? As I said, lack also is a reserved keyword in MySQL. You see it at MariaDB. Lack always shows you the row before the other row. So Moscow, London, Berlin, Madrid, Roma, and so on. So if you know which row is which, result is before that. Same here. And lead is vice versa, of course. As I said in my example, I just forgot the DESC at the end. So lead is the after. So it's just that you see it's sorted vice versa. It's always what it's, what comes next. So Brussels, Minsk, Vienna, Paris, Rome, Madrid. What comes next? Yeah, I'm also done here. It's, I just have to slide. My MySQL is similar. as you see. Yeah, and more about window functions, there are lots of more. You can find lists and also more descriptions in mywirldb.com, knowledge base, English libraries, window functions, and on dev.mysql.com, docs, refman 8.0, English window functions descriptions.html. So they both have a good documentation for it. Yes, and that, thanks for listening. I think both CTEs and window functions are very, very fancy stuff, and it's good to use them.